Pavarotti with Ness and Dorma, just absolutely amazing and so powerful, it made a young French boy turn to a life of music. Vincent Niclo, a French singing star, has grown up a bit since then. He sold over a million albums, was personally invited to perform with Celine Dion, and has even had a bit of a dabble on the catwalk. He joins me now. Vincent, good to chat with you. How are you?
Hello, Danny. You're going to make me cry.
Well, no, I gather that song nearly did. That's that clip of Pavarotti.
Good start.
What was it like when you heard Ness and Dorma? Because that inspired you. What was it like when you heard that for the first time?
I was in my bedroom. I was in shock because I didn't expect this. And when I heard the song, it went through my heart and I cried. And I couldn't explain why, but I was full of emotion. So that day, I discovered how powerful a voice could be and go through the hearts of people. And from that day, I decided to go to classical side of my voice. And I took a lot of lessons with an opera teacher, and it changed my life.
Why the decision to go down the classical route? Because I guess French boys of your age at that time were more into pop or rock. Why classical?
Because I was listening to pop music. And I never had that kind of emotion with pop voices. And from that day, it changed my life because it was the only way for me to have so much emotion, to cry because of a voice. It never happened to me. So I was on shock. And I decided to turn my whole life into that side because it was fantastic for me. Unbelievable.
Let's zoom ahead a few years, and you eventually had the chance to sing alongside Pavarotti. What did that feel like when you're standing next to the man, performing next to the man who inspired you at the beginning?
Yeah, the TV you're talking about was like a dream for me because he wasn't there. He was unfortunately dead. But they did it, you know, with the technical.
Wow.
Yes. And his voice was mixed with my voice, so it was such an honor for me. But he wasn't on stage with me. But for me, it was like a big gift because when I hear you just put the Pavarotti voice and I nearly cried because I can't explain why, but it goes through my heart and it gives me so much emotion.
Your dad was a big inspiration. He was quite a big push in the early years, wasn't he?
Yes. And my dad teach me everything. He teach me music theory. He teach me how to behave in a song, because it's not only about singing. It's also each word in the song has to be at the right place, and that's how you talk to people, I think. So that's what I try to do. And he explained me so many other things. I used to sing with him, and he was so fantastic with me.
At what point, I mean, I guess many people have a dream of singing and a dream about making it professionally, but at what point did you start to think, actually, this could be a career, this could be my job, I could make a living out of this, rather than just singing in the shower, I could make something of this?
It's very simple. Actually, I never asked myself that question. It was like for me, I don't know how to explain. I was born like this. I mean, I don't know if it's because of my father and I wanted to be like my father, or if I had this inside of me. I think it's both. But I always say I will sing in a subway or in front of a big audience, but I will always sing. And that's what I'm doing. I mean, I have the chance to sing in front of big audiences now, but it wasn't always the case. I mean, it has been hard for me to start. Mm. It's been long, but I couldn't imagine my life a different way.
Do you enjoy that? What's the joy? Is the joy, I'll go from one extreme to the other, is the joy being in a studio, maybe just you in front of the microphone, and where you can just focus on the quality of the performance, the quality of the sound, the quality of your voice, or is the joy the other way around, performing to a large audience where it's live, anything could happen, but you get that buzz from the audience? Which of the two do you prefer?
To be honest, totally honest, I don't really like the studio because it's really cold. I mean, there is no immediate reflection of what you did. I mean, but when you sing in front of an audience, big one or little one, it's, immediately you have the feedback of what you did. And also, when people listen to my music, I'm not there. So I cannot, you know, have reactions in live. But when you sing in front of people, you have the reaction immediately, and they like it or not, but you know it. You know what I mean?
You get that buzz straight away. You get that warmth straight away. You know when exactly. That magic is there on that night. Hey, tell me about a couple of other things, because you've achieved so much already. You trained with members of the Paris Opera. That must have been fantastic.
Yes, that's true. It was a big chance for me. I mean, that guy Thierry is he's a fantastic guy, and he teach me so well, like opera things, and it changed my life, and it changed my voice also. But what I like the most is not to be only on the same kind of music. And for the moment, my French audience, they allow me to do that, to go from musical theater and then to make like a studio album, and then go to Rat Pack music and then to opera things. It's fantastic for me because I'm not stuck into like a kind of music only.
So a variety of styles in your music, but also in your past and maybe current, a variety of jobs. You've also been a very successful model.
Yes, but modeling was part of my life, but I didn't really like it. It was only a way for me to earn money and to get money very fast.
Yeah.
When
that
I realized...
That sounds good, though.
Yes, sounds good to everybody. I needed money because I had no money, and lessons are very expensive, music lessons and your voice lessons. So I needed a lot of money, and I didn't have a lot of time because I was always running for castings, and I was also working into music. So it was the quickest way for me to earn money and to put that money into my real career. Which is singing.
Has that helped in any way, maybe accidentally, I know, helping you, I don't know, with stage presence on stage, with knowing how you look on stage, with how you hold yourself on stage? Has that helped in any way with the real career now of singing?
No, that helps me a lot on the, on the artistic part. I mean, for example, I know how to react in front of a camera. I'm used to it. I'm not afraid. I know my best profile. I know what I can give very quickly. For example, in a video clip or for a photo shoot, that helps a lot for sure. But it's not the part that I like the most.
Well, talking about the part you like the most, you've achieved great success already. You even got to perform in front of Celine Dion. What's it like performing in front of somebody who you know is recognized for their skill, for their talent, and there's you performing in front of them?
At the beginning, it's a nightmare.
I bet.
Especially when you have to sing all by myself in front of her with the big note. But I said to myself, it's such a big opportunity, a huge gift from life and from her, that I couldn't, escape. So I did it, and I hope I did it well. But from that day, my life changed completely. And it was a booster. People were stopping me in the street, asking me, "Oh, what you did yesterday? What fantastic!" Blah 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 blah. It really changed my life. And add to that, Céline asked me to do a opening act in Paris for big concerts, and it was unbelievable for me.
That success story goes from strength to strength. You've just signed for the Sony Masterworks label. Your new album, Romantique, comes out in the next few weeks. We'll finish with a track.
20th of May.
We'll come out with a track from that, She, the classic Charles Aznavour track. Yep. Vincent, an absolute delight to chat with you today. Many thanks for joining us. Continued success.
I hope so. Thank you very much for hosting. Thank you.
She may be the face I can't forget. A trace of pleasure or regret. Maybe my treasure or the price I have to pay. She may be the song that summer sings. Maybe the chill that autumn brings. Maybe 100 different things within the measure of a day. She may be the beauty or the beast. Maybe the famine or the feast. May turn each day into a heaven or a hell. She may be the mirror of my dreams. A smile reflected in a stream. She may not be what she may seem inside her shell. She who always seems so happy in a crowd, whose eyes can be so private and so proud. No one's allowed to see them when they cry. She may be the love that cannot hope to last. May come to me from shadows of the past that I remember till the day take laughter and their tears and make them all my souvenirs. For where she goes, I forgot to be. The meaning of my life is